Hi everyone, welcome to mock classes. Today we will see in the lexical analysis. Lexical analysis today I will complete it in the whole things. Okay, whatever in the GATE exams and other exams will come. Everything I will complete it and lexical analysis. Okay, so maybe it is the lengthy video, 1 hour. Whenever you watch the video, then you will be see the complete video of the lexical analysis. So first we will see in the phases of a compiler. Last session also I have uploaded the one video phases of a compiler, but that times in the last phase code generations is already hide. That is why I am again re-video of the phases of the compiler. Okay, so first we will see in the phases of a compiler. In the first phase, name is lexical analysis, then syntax analysis, semantic analysis, intermediate code generator, code optimizer and code generator. Okay, so then lexical analysis will take first high level language. Any user, any programmer, whenever write the program, they are writing in the high level language. What is high level language? High level language just like Java, for example, Java, C++, C, all are the high level language, and these language computer doesn't understand. So that is why we need a compiler, any translator, not a compiler, interpreter, okay, assembler. These times we need to convert high level language to machine level language. So that is why high level language first going to the lexical analysis phase. So these are the phases whenever we are using the compiler. So then high level language first taken by the input of lexical analysis is character. One by one character lexical analysis will read it and then produce tokens. It is a set of tokens. It will be produced by the lexical analysis. Now syntax analysis as an input will take set of tokens and output will take as a parse tree. Then afterwards semantic analysis will come. Semantic analysis phase will take as an input parse tree and generate again is parse tree, but it is not a parse tree, it is semantically verified by the parse tree. Semantically verified means it will be checked by the systems. Semantically verified parse tree, that means it is meaningful or not, it will be checked by the semantic analysis. Now come intermediate code generator. Intermediate code generator will take as an input semantically verified parse tree and output will generate three address code. Whatever in I will show you the examples. Okay, three address code, that means every statement has a three variables. We can use it three or less than, not more than. So that is why its name is three address code. Now code optimizer. Code optimizer will take as an input three address code and it will be represent intermediate representation. Intermediate representation, that means reduce the three address code. It will be take three variables also and less also, and otherwise it was reduce the line. Three address codes, then intermediate representation, it will reduce the lines. Now code generator as an input will take intermediate representation and output will generate assembly code. It will be generate assembly. That is why high level language to convert to the assembly level language. Now we can see that symbol table and error handler. Symbol tables are connected to every phase. Why it is connected to every phase? Because we need, suppose modified the program, many times we are removing the some variables just like three address codes, so that times we need a symbol. So every phase required a symbol table. Now come error handler also every phases it will be going on. Why? Because lexical analysis will take as an input character by character, and then output will generate set of tokens. Then that times also some errors will come, so it will be removed by the lexical analysis. Then syntax analysis also will work, and the some removing part, and then semantic analysis also. Every phases it's required the error handler, because every phases are checking one by one things. Okay, one by one things. Now come and the first session I told that compiler has two major parts. One is analysis, and next is synthesis. Analysis and synthesis phase. So analysis phase will come lexical analysis, syntax analysis and semantic analysis. These are called analysis phase. Okay, these are called analysis phase. Now synthesis phase, intermediate code generator, code optimizer and code generator. These are the synthesis phase. Okay, so then analysis phase, it will be take a input as a program, and it will be then afterwards create the intermediate code generator. It will create the intermediate code generator. Which one? Analysis phase. And analysis phase using the symbol tables also as a storing the variables, storing the data. But synthesis phase will take intermediate code generator as an input, and it will be represent the target code. Which one is target code? This one. Assembly code is called a target code. Okay. And high level language, this one is called a source language. So you can say that source language will take as an input in the analysis phase, and it will be create the intermediate code generation. And synthesis phase will take as an input intermediate code generation, and it will be generate target code. So these are the phases, two major phases. And now we will see tools. Which tools we are using? Lexical analysis tools name is, wait, I am changing the marker. Lexical analysis tools name is Lex. Lexical analysis, if in a compiler, in the special tools, if you are using it, so the lexical analysis phase, we are using the tools, that is Lex. Syntax analysis phase, we are using Yuck, yet another compiler. And in the whole program, if you are in the whole phases, if you are using the tools, that name is Lens. It is LAN. It is Lens. Lens we are using. And now, if you can see, then in the yet another compiler, like this one, we are using the spatial and the phases. If you are going in the parsers, so that is LALR. Look ahead, LR. This is the bottom of parser name. Look ahead, LR. Whenever we are going to the syntax analysis phase in the tomorrow's sessions, so that times I will explain you what is look ahead LR, so that times you can understood that. But if in the questions has given only the which phase we are using in the YEC tools, so that times if LALR has not given, so then directly you can mark it in the syntax analysis. And lexical analysis, another name is scanner. Why? Because it is scanning the whole program. That is why its another name is scanner. Now syntax analysis, another name is parser. Okay. And first four phases are called front end phase. First four phases are called front end phase. And last bottom of two phases are called back end phase. Okay, last two phases are called back end phase. Now parses I here we are using in the lexical analysis phase in the regular expression grammar. We are using regular expression. Okay, in the lexical analysis phase we are using the grammar, that name is regular expression. And syntax analysis phase, using the grammar, name is context free grammar. So the in the compiler some parts are attached to the TOC, theory of computation. Okay, some whenever I will teach in the theory of computation, that times also we require the these phases also. Okay, that's like in the regular expression and context free grammar. Okay, so now we will see the examples of lexical analysis one by one phases. Okay, so first and they're taking the one example, w equal to x plus y into z. Okay, so x plus y into z, I already told that lexical analyzer first will take as an input one by one character. So then this is the one by, it is called a patterns. It is called a patterns. Whenever here in the one by one variable is given, sometimes in the one word string like this is given, so that times in the one step one word is called a patterns. And legim, suppose just like for example has written four is a one word, so then f is a one legim, o is a other legim, like it is called a legim. And legim will be identified by the lexical analyzer. Okay, so then here w equal to x plus y into z has given. Later on I will tell you that what is called legim and patterns and how it will be matched by the lexical analyzer. Now we will see the simple statement w equal to x plus y into z. So then we knew that lexical analyzer as a taken as an input is a character. Okay, so character one by one character will take as an input, and then it will be generate as an output token, set of tokens. So set of tokens means how many characters are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the character, and this is called a operator. And w x y z, we can say that is a identifier also. Okay, so then lexical analyzer first find out the identifier and then it will be generated as a tokens. So then now tokens, how we will write it? Id1, this one w, it will be converted by the identifier, because whatever variables we are using, all are called a identifier. So then id1 equal to id2 plus id3 plus into id4. You can write anything, okay, but identifier, you knew that every variables, every patterns is called a identifier, and identifier will be identified by the tokens. Okay, now syntax analyzer will come. Syntax analyzer take as an input these identifiers, and it will be generated by the output of a parse tree. So then how it will be generated as a parse tree? The parse tree, first always remember that here in the operator using plus and multiplication. So then which one is the higher precedence? Higher precedence is always it is the multiplication. Okay, and sometimes it, if inside of the bracket has given, so that times bracket we will solve just like a mathematics. So first in the here in the higher precedence is id3 plus id4, so that is why I've taken id3 into id4. These two identifiers will take and multiply it, and output will become here. Okay, and then now whatever output will come, whatever answers will come, it will be adding for by the id2. So that is why whatever answers will come here, whenever we will be multiply it, and then this output will be plus it by the id 2, and this plus plus it will become in the equal to symbol. It is equivalent id 1 equal to. So like this parse tree we will be generated. First we'll write in the higher precedence, then in the lower precedence. Okay, which one is higher precedence? Higher precedence means whenever you are writing in the last, first we will solve it. This is called a higher precedence. Now comes syntax analyzer. Syntax analyzer, I didn't write here. Why? Because syntax analyzer also it will be generated as a parse tree, but it will be checked by the semantically verified or not. Okay, this parse tree will check by the syntax analyzer, then it will be check it by the semantically verified or not. Semantically verified parse tree. Semantically verified, so same parse tree will generate, and but it will be check here it's meaningful or not, its pattern is matched or not. These things will be checked by the semantic analyzer. Now come intermediate code generator. Intermediate code generator, that means it will be take as an input semantically verified parse tree. Okay, and output will be generate three address code. The three address code, it is, that means in the one line we can write only the three address, that means t1 id3 id4, just like in the one variable, two variable, three variable. So that means three variable, it is called a three address codes. We can take it as a one times one line, you can say that. So here you can see in the questions has given 1, 2, 3, 4. Four addresses are given. Okay, but now we will convert in the intermediate code generator in the three address code. So first we will be write in the multiplication, that is why. And here we are using the temporary variable t1, that means temporary variable t1 equal to id3 into id4, and whatever output will come it will be stored by the t1. And then now T2, what temporary variable again, because whatever answers has given in the T1 and we are adding to ID2. So that is why T1 plus ID2, it will add it and then store in the T2, temporary variable 2. And then now T2, whatever answers are there, we will move to the ID1, because ID1, that means W equal to has given. Okay, so then this is the three address code. And now code optimizer take as an input in the three address code, and it will be take as an output in the intermediate representation means it will be reduce the presentation. Representation. Okay, intermediate representation. Intermediate represent, that means reduce the lines. Reduce the line, just like you can see that here ID equal to T2, it is the extra line. Okay, so this line it will be removed by the code optimizer. Code how? That means temporary one, it is the needed. So that is why ID3 into ID4 we have written already. And then ID1 identifier one here, T2 place, that means temporary variable place, we can write the identifier one. So identifier one equal to T1 plus identifier two. So it will be reduced by the line. Now code generator, it will be take in the intermediate representation as an input, and output will be generated as an assembly code. How we will write? Suppose first has given what? Z, and Z we are representing as a ID4. So that is why move ID4 to register 2, because assembly code, whenever we are storing the data, that we are using the register. So that is why ID4 data will be stored in the R2, register 2. And then ID3 data, Y, storing to the register 1. Now we have all store in the two variables R2 and R1. Now we can multiply, because here two variables 2 multiply it. So that is why multiplication mul R1 into R2, here multiply also, and then it will be store the data in the R1. Okay, and now R2 is empty because R2 and R1, whenever we are multiplying and then afterwards storing, this is the assembly code has the benefits. We are taking in the two register and then automatically this one will be empty. Okay, so then it will be move, multiply, and then afterwards storing the data in the R1, and R2 is now empty. So then now R2 places we can store the data X. So that is why move ID 2 to R2. Identifier 2 data we are moving to R2. And then now R2 whenever has taken, multiplication has done. So then now we will add it. So addition R2 R1. You can write anything, R1 R2 also you can write it. It is also possible. Okay. So this place we can write R1 or R1 and R2 also. Anyone you can write it. I have written already R2 and R1. Adding and then storing the data after the adding R2. So that is why move ID 1 to. Move ID 1 to. It is R2. Okay. It is move ID 1 to R2. Otherwise you can write it. Suppose this statement if you will write. So then move ID 1 to R1. Okay, move ID 1 to R1. So this is the examples of the lexical analysis, all the phases. And syntax analyzer is called a heart of a compiler. Heart of a compiler. Which one? Syntax analyzer. Okay, syntax analyzer is called a heart of a compiler. Now we will see in the some parts of lexical, what is the benefits, and lexical analyzer, what is the advantage, disadvantage. Okay, now we will see the interface to the lexical analyzer. Okay, so interface to the lexical analyzer, first input, then lexical analyzer parser. Input has given, input to lexical analyzer in the interface is given first. Input as a program, whatever program we have written in the any language, in the high level language. Okay, and the lexical analyzer work to take as an input either read the characters. Okay, read one by one character, and then it will generate the token. One character for the token, that means leg genes. Here we are using the word in the leg genes, patterns. Okay, patterns, that means suppose I told that we are writing suppose compiler, that means if we are reading one by one character, that is the leg genes. And in the one word if we are taking as a string, it is called a patterns. So then it will generate by the patterns, and it will matched by the tokens. It is matched by the tokens. Okay, so then tokens, and then next tokens if you want. So that times we are going to the get next tokens from the lexical analyzer. One character already we have read, and then again we are going to the input program. Then we'll push back to the character. If you need any character, so then again we'll push it. Suppose sometimes in the char variable I have written char, so by mistakes I have written in the double R. Okay, so that times also it will be rectified by the lexical analyzer. Afterwards we will see. So that is why I read one by one character, and it will be pushed back the character if it is needed. And then now lexical already generated by the tokens, it will get in the next tokens, that means next word. So that times it again going to the lexical analyzer and taken back to the tokens, it will be generated. Now in between of the two, symbol tables are there, lexical analyzer and parsers, both are using the symbol tables. Okay, in the last session we have seen that already. In the symbol tables every phases are connected. Why? Because every phases we need something different. Okay, so that is why we need the symbol table. Here also parsers also it will be take and then again come back. Now we will see in the lexical analyzer and parsers will generate is a producer consumer pair. In both of them when connect to each other, then it is called a producer consumer pair. Producer consumer producer consumer pair. Why produce? It will be produce the data and parsers will consume the data. Lexical analyzer produce the data and parsers will consume the data. That is why name is producer consumer pair in both of two. And then now size of the buffer, it is different. It in both of two, in between only the in the constant by the size of the buffer. Whenever lexical and the buffer is full, then lexical analyzer cannot be proceed. If buffer is full, so then lexical analyzer cannot be proceed. When and parser just in the just opposite. When if buffer is empty, so then parsers cannot be proceed. Okay, so it is the difference of the only size of the buffer. Both of two in between, if you will see that it is the size of the buffer, and both of two in between is called a producer consumer pair. Why? Because lexical analyzer produce the characters one by one, and parsers will tokens. That means what? It will be generated by the lexical, it will be consumed by the parser. That is why it will be consumed. Okay, so producer consumer pair. Now we will see lexical analysis module. Lexical analysis module, the lexical analyzer is a routine called Lexen. Lexical analyzer is a routine called Lexen that is called by the parser to find tokens. Why you are needed the Lexen? Because to find the tokens, whenever we are finding the token, that times we are using the Lexen. Okay, now we will see in the lexical errors. Okay, lexical errors and it is a rectify by the lexical analyzer. So we can say that it is the recovery of the lexical errors. So now first we will see delete an extraneous character. Extraneous character, that means suppose I have written CHARRR, it is a data type, character data type, but by mistake I have written in the double R. So that times lexical analyzer, wherever programs will check character by character, so that times it will be reduce the that character, delete it. Okay, so it is deleted. So deleting by an extraneous character. Now we will see inserting a missing character. Insert the character. Suppose same examples we have written, CHARRR has written. Okay, but you knew that character data type R also will be there, so then it will be missing the character here. So that times it will be insert the data. So insert the extra variable, whatever it is needed. Now replacing an incorrect character by a character. Replacing means replace it in the incorrect. Suppose this one is incorrect character, again you will write incorrect character and it will be correct by the correct character. So then it will be take like this CHAR. So that is the replacing an incorrect character by the correct character. Whatever correct data type, it will be take by the automatically. These are the automatically will take by the lexical analyzer's recovery, error recovery. Now transposing two adjacent character, that means here we can see that only the one character can change one character, but here we can two adjacent, that means suppose in the while I want to write while, but by mistake I have written like this. Okay, so here you can say that two characters has changed. टू कैरेक्टर्स, तो टू कैरेक्टर्स, टू एडजेसेंट कैरेक्टर, एडजेसेंट ई एल, सो देन इट विल बी चेंज, इट विल बी ट्रांसपोज इट लाइक दिस, तो देन एल ई, टू लेटर्स, टू कैरेक्टर्स आर ट्रांसपोज इट, ओके, दैट मीन्स रिप्ल एक्सचेंज इज लाइक ट्रांसपोज इट लाइक दिस, ओके, सो दिस इज द transpose of two adjacent character. So these are the error recovery by the lexical analyzer, and one most important things by the lexical analyzer recovery is white space. It cannot take blank white space and comment section, okay, so whenever we are recognized by the tokens, whenever count by the tokens, so that times white space, that means blank space and any comments, this one it will be not take by the lexical analyzer, okay, so it will be remove it, and no extra line, no new line. Now we will see in these some important points by the lexical analyzer. Our tokens can represent more than one lexemes, more than one. In a token, we can represent more than one lexemes. One lexeme, that means I told that in the one word, it is a pattern. Okay, so one by one, later it will be recognized and match it by the lexical analyzer. Now we will see in the next point, token types and its attribute uniquely identify by a lexeme. Okay, so then token type, which type of tokens? Okay, and what is the its attribute? It is uniquely identified by a lexemes because it will be check. Now RE stands for regular expression. Regular expression. So then regular expressions are used to specify patterns. Whenever we are checking the pattern, that times we are using the grammar, it is called a regular expression. And finite automata used to recognize the tokens. Whenever characters, that means patterns, we are matching, that times we are using the grammar regular expression. And machines we are using to recognize the tokens, that is the finite automata. In the TOC, we can see that regular expression, it is a grammar, it is recognized by a finite automata machine. So here also in the lexical analyzer, we are using the grammar regular expressions to recognize the character, and finite automata to recognize the tokens. Next, tokens can be identified by a, which one is tokens, how we will identify? So then it is identified by keywords, constant, identifiers, operators and symbols. Now we will see these some examples. One examples I am taking, suppose s equal to a plus b into 30, a plus b into 30. So then which one is keywords, which one is constant, which one is identifiers, it will be checked. Here constant 30, 30 is a constant value, that is constant value. S, a, b, all are identifier, all are identifier. Now equal to plus into, multiply, these are the operators and symbols, you can say that these are the operators and symbols is a semicolon is a symbol. So these statements we can see that everything's okay, at constant, s, a, b, identifiers, equal to, plus, multiplication, operators and semicolon as a symbols. Okay, so we have seen everything of the lexical analyzer and lexical analysis parts, and next sessions I will explain in the questions of most expected questions and some previous year questions by the GATE in the lexical analyzers. Okay, and if you want to join the any group of the Telegram channel, I have a Telegram channel in the mock classes, you can see in the about sections as given, so that place also you can go and click in the Telegram button, so then you can directly join from there. Okay, thank you.